Yes, a very good morning to all of you. Always join your class well in time. And moreover, exit your class when the period is ended. Because yesterday I was making the record of attendance. Some of the children, they are saying, ma'am, just before 5 minutes I exit. So better, eh? Apna, in the end of the lecture, till the end of the lecture, you have to remain there. Only then your record of attendance will be with me. Otherwise, I'll mark you absent. And this time attendance is going to be very, very important, as it will be part of your portfolio that is to be sent to CBSE afterwards. So be very careful about that, right? Anyways, so yesterday we have finished chapter number 8, trigonometry. Today we will start with the next chapter, chapter number 9, some application of trigonometry. What is the meaning of application? Meaning of application is that when we learn some concept and we apply that concept, that knowledge in the different fields to realize different aims. For example, suppose one person is doing the course of fashion designing, right? He or she has learned the little tips with the help of which he or she can excel in this field. And afterward, the person applies his or her knowledge to develop the different designs of the dresses, right? Similarly, when you learned about trigonometric functions, their values at a certain angles, now it is a time to learn about their applications in the, you can say, real world, right? As far as trigonometry is concerned, we all know that the distance of the between the stars, the distance of Earth from Moon, Earth from Sun, Sun from Earth, Sun from Moon, etc. These kind of distances, navigation problems, height and distance problems, these all are calculated with the help of trigonometry. So as far as our chapter is concerned, there will be certain problems which deals with the, you can say, height and distance concept with the help of trigonometry. So this is what we are going to do in this chapter. So I will share screen on which I will write a definition and all that. It's up to you. You want to see the videos afterwards. You want to take the screenshots, whatever you want to do to make your notes, whatever is suitable to you, you do accordingly. Okay, so what we have to learn in starting, we have to learn three very important things on the basis of which we will do some questions based on application of trigonometry. Suppose we are having, ground level. This is the ground level. I would like to take it as, jaise ki maine figure mein liya hua hai. Same I would like to take. Suppose here it is building C point, this is B point, and here is the point A. Right? This is the building. And this is the top of the building. Right? There is some person, this is the ground level, which is usually known as horizontal level. Horizontal level, right? So one thing we have to see, first of all, I read it from notes and then I will explain. I'm not going to write these on the board. I will just give its explanation on the board. There is one observer at the point A. Here the observer is standing. Who is the observer? Who is going to see something, right? This observer looking at the top of the building, right? Observer is looking at the top of the building. And When this observer is looking at the top of the building, there will be some angle that this horizontal level where observer is standing and the line in the direction of which observer is looking at the top. This line in the direction of which the, you can say, observation has been made is known as line of sight. इसको हम बोलते हैं लाइन ऑफ साइट. सो फर्स्ट डेफिनेशन इज लाइन ऑफ साइट. यू कैन सी ऑन द, यू कैन से नोट्स, इट इज ड्रॉन फ्रॉम द आई ऑफ एन ऑब्जर्वर टू द पॉइंट इन द ऑब्जेक्ट व्यूड बाय द ऑब्जर्वर. व्हाट ही वांट्स टू से, हाउ टू ड्रॉ द लाइन ऑफ साइट, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. हाउ टू ड्रॉ द लाइन ऑफ साइट, टू ड्रॉ द लाइन ऑफ साइट वी हैव टू स्टार्ट विद द आई ऑफ एन ऑब्जर्वर and we have to reach at the point where the observer is looking at. Starting with the eye of observer, reaching at the point where the observer is looking, the line so made is called line of sight. That same thing I have written on the notes, that line of sight is drawn from eye of an observer to the point in the object viewed by the observer. अब कुछ लोग कहते हैं कि ये भी तो हमारी लाइन ऑफ साइट हुई. वी हैव टू सी दैट लाइन ऑफ साइट शुड बी कंसर्न्ड विद द पॉइंट वेयर द ऑब्जर्वर इज लुकिंग, नॉट एनी अदर पॉइंट. इट शुड बी रिलेटेड टू आवर क्वेश्चन. इट शुड बी रिलेटेड टू दैट एरिया ओनली वेयर द ऑब्जर्वर इज लुकिंग एट. नाउ सेकेंड थिंग विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन. नाउ सी, sometimes we are you can say standing below, and the thing that we are going to observe is you can say above us. For example, suppose we are standing in the school ground, right, and we are looking our friend who is standing in the corridor of the library, right? So what it means that observer is at the lower position and the object or the thing or the person that the observer is looking, that is on the you can say above the horizontal level. So what I have written, if the object which is to be viewed is above the horizontal level, then the angle made by the line of sight with the horizontal level is called angle of object, angle of elevation. Let me explain. This is the object where the observer is looking at. And make one thing very, very clear, that what is the position of the object with respect to the horizontal level. This is the horizontal level, and position of the object as far as the horizontal level is concerned, it is above the horizontal level. In that case, this line of sight, whatever angle it will make with the horizontal, that will be called angle of elevation, right? This will be called angle of elevation. Then come to the next definition, angle of depression. Sometimes you might be standing, you might be sitting in the balcony of your house, right? And there is some, you can say, football on the playground. Yahan pe football hai ground pe. So you are sitting in the balcony of your house, and you are looking at that football, right? Or you can say you are standing in the corridor of the school, and some, you can say, basketball match, it is going on in the school playground. You are at the top, and the thing you are looking at, it is at the bottom. Now the thing is, first of all, to see the angle, we need two things. One is the horizontal level, another is the line of sight, right? Horizontal level is always drawn from the eye of observer, and even line of sight is drawn from the eye of observer. This is eye of observer, I draw the horizontal level, and this is the object to be seen, and I draw the line of sight. Now this is the observer, this is the horizontal line, horizontal level, and this is the object which is to be viewed. So what we learned, we have learned that this time the object which the person is going to view is lower to the horizontal level that I have written on the notes. If the object which is viewed is below the horizontal level, then angle made by, this is a line of sight, we all know. So angle made by line of sight with the horizontal level in that case will be known as angle of depression. Isko hum bolenge angle of depression. So these are the three basic definition on the by using which we'll do the questions related to trigonometry. So once again, I'm going to repeat three very important definition on the basis of which questions will be discussed. So first is, you should know that there is a line of sight which is drawn from the eye of observer to the point which is to be viewed. There is a horizontal level that is to be drawn from the eye of observer and in the horizontal direction, right? If the object viewed is above the horizontal level, then the angle made by this line of sight with the horizontal is called angle of elevation. On the other hand, if the observer is at the top, that means it is above the observer is at the top, that is, it is above the object which is seen, that means horizontal level is above the object which is seen, then the angle made by line of sight with the horizontal level is called angle of depression. So these three, you can say, definitions, they are going to be very, very important in the coming chapter. So let us start the chapter 9th, exercise 9.1. Students, it's going to be very amazing for you, as this chapter, when you'll do this chapter, all the knowledge that you have gained in the previous chapter, that will be used, and you will find that as if you are solving some problem of the real life. So that's why this chapter is going to be very, very interesting for you people. So let us start with exercise 9.1. First question. First question of exercise 9.1 is, and one thing more I want to tell you, that sometimes in the questions of the exercise, the figures, they are made, but it is not necessary that the figures which are there in the book in the exam also the examiner will give you the same figure. So you have to learn that how, according to the question, you have to make the figure. So let us see that how, by reading out the question, we'll make the figure. But the question is, circus artist is climbing a 20 meter long rope which is tightly stretched and tied from the top of a vertical pole to the ground. Find the height of the pole if the angle made by the rope with the ground level is 30 degree. Puri statement maine kar di, kuch bhi hame samajh nahi aaya. Anyhow, we'll read it step by step, make the figure, and accordingly we'll get the information. First of all, there is ground level, which is given to be BC. And there is a pole, which is standing on the ground. This is pole. AB is pole. Right? So there is a circus artist. Manlo, ye maine circus artist bana diya. Circus artist ne kya karna hai? He has to climb the rope. And where the rope is attached, to the pole from the ground, and so tightly that there is no slack when we are, you can say, tied the rope to the ground from the top, right? So this is the figure. Circus artist has to climb to this rope, which is 20 meter long. This rope is 20 meter long. This is pole. This is ground level. What we want to find? We want to find, and moreover, one more thing, find the height of the pole if the angle made by the rope with the ground level is 30 degree. This is rope, this is ground level, and this angle, this is given to be 30 degree. If the figure is not available, with the help of the, you can say, question, you can make it very easily if you know the concepts, right? Now see, whenever we'll do application of trigonometry, in the question, we have to search a right angle triangle. No doubt, here only one right angle triangle is there in front of you. No need to search it out. Aapke samne ek right angle triangle hai. First requirement is satisfied itself. Apne aap hi hame dikh raha hai ek right angle triangle. Because we know whenever we are going to use the trigonometric ratios, we have to work in right angle triangle. That is made. Now, what to find? We have to find the length of the pole. this is the length of the pole which is to be found. So one thing I want to tell you, whenever you start the application of trigonometry based question, you have to write the description of the figure. How to write the description of the figure? Whatever you are understanding about the figure, you have to write it in your own words. Anyone can write it in one way or the other way. There is no one you can say unique way to write the information. You can write it in your own way, but that should be logical. That should be according to the question. As I'm writing here, AB is the pole and AC is equal to 20 meter is the row. BC is ground level ya fir horizontal level, whatever you want to like write, ground level, such that angle ACB is equal to 30 degree. This is what I am writing. Whatever I am learning about the figure, whatever I am looking at, that what these dimension represent, what I am writing it in my own words, and same you can write it in your own words, right? So this is a right angle triangle in which this is to be calculated. Trigonometry I am going to use. What I will write? In right angled triangle ABC. Right? Now always keep one thing in mind. When we are going to use trigonometric ratios in such kind of question, trigonometric ratios, what I can use sine theta is equal to perpendicular over hypotenuse. I can use tan theta is equal to perpendicular over base. I can use cos theta is equal to base over hypotenuse. Anything I can use, but it is up to me. It is my understanding that what should be what should I use and what should be very useful to use. See, when we are going to write some trigonometric, you can say, identity using this figure, ek baat aapne yaad rakhni hai. You have to take one side which is unknown most of the time and the other side which is known. So and one more thing, one side which is to be find out. So mujhe find kya karna hai? AB, maine AB likh diya. Over what is given to me? AC, maine over AC likh diya. Now I see this AB over AC kya ban raha hai? Perpendicular over hypotenuse. And you might have remembered, you should know rather right now, that what is perpendicular over hypotenuse? We know this is sine theta. Perpendicular over hypotenuse is sine theta. But in place of theta, which angle we are having? 30. So we will write it is equal to sine theta. This step contains the whole concept of the chapter that we are doing, that how we are writing it. If we are writing it intelligently, then no one will stop us to find the correct answer. Ye cheez bahut important hai. If you are knowing this step in each and every question, we are writing this step minutely, then the half of the job is done. So I am taking one thing which is to be find out, taking the another thing which is given, then looking at that what is perpendicular over hypotenuse. According to my previous knowledge, perpendicular over hypotenuse, this is sine theta, but in place of theta I have to replace 30 according to the figure, right? Now let us replace the values. What is the value of AB that I have to find, that is height of the pole? And what is the value of AC? This is given to be 20, this is sine 30, and we know sine 30 is root 3 over 2, right? So this implies AB is equal to 20 root 3 over 2. 20 and 2 get cancelled. So AB is equal to 10 root 3. And in the end, you will write, therefore, height of the pole, this is equal to 10 root 3. So Madhav is raising hand. Let me take his query. Yes, Madhav, what do you want to ask?
I'm sine 30 1 by 2 nahi hoga.
Speak.
Ma'am, sine 30 1 by 2 nahi hoga.
Madhav, speak loudly. Voice is not audible.
Ma'am, sine 30 की value 1 by 2 नहीं होगी.
Speaker is taking the variation, but your voice is not audible. I can't hear you. Might be some problem from your side. Keep on speaking. Yes, Bhumika, what is your doubt? चलिए anyhow. So this is the first question of the exercise. Very easy. You will do step by step, from easy to complex we'll go. सो अगेन राघव अरोड़ा इज रेजिंग हैंड. हाँ जी राघव, एनी प्रॉब्लम?
मैम साइन 30 की वैल्यू 1/2 आएगी.
जस्ट अ मिनट, वेट. यस राघव, स्पीक अप.
साइन 30 की वैल्यू 1/2 आएगी.
सॉरी सॉरी सॉरी, मैंने गलती से यहाँ पे रूट की बट. थैंक यू राघव. सो दिस इज 10 मीटर, राइट? सो माधव ने एक स्माइली देके भेजा है कि मैं यही बताना चाहता था. ओके माधव, योर आइडिया और योर एक्सप्रेशन हैव बीन टोल्ड बाय योर वन ऑफ योर वेरी गुड फ्रेंड, राइट? चलिए एनी हाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर सेकेंड. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज, अ ट्री ब्रेक्स, ऐसा क्वेश्चन हमने सेवेंथ में भी किया था. अ ट्री ब्रेक्स ड्यू टू स्टॉर्म एंड द ब्रोकन पार्ट बेंड्स सो दैट द टॉप ऑफ द ट्री टचेस द ग्राउंड मेकिंग एन एंगल 30 डिग्री. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर हैविंग द ट्री. इफ यू वॉन्ट योर सेल्फ टू गेट प्रेजेंट इन द रजिस्टर इन द स्कूल रिकॉर्ड, स्टे ट्यून्ड विद द लेक्चर टिल एंड. डोंट से मी मैंने 5 मिनट पहले एग्जिट कर दिया था. This will not be allowed at all. चलिए, so there is a tree. Let AB be the tree and let C be the point from where it is broken. Right? What happened? Due to storm, this tree, it has been broken. And the broken part, this BC, it bends down towards ground. ये मैं यहाँ पे ground level बना लूँ और इसको यहाँ से ये broken part यहाँ से गिरा. B लिखने की बजाय, same point लिखने की बजाय मैं इसको D लिख रही हूँ. Right? The broken part, this BC, it should be equal to BD. So, मैं तो इसको थोड़ा increase कर दूँ. This broken part, BC, it bends down towards the ground. And when it is bending down towards the ground, it is making angle 30 degree with the ground. This broken part, when it bends towards the ground, it is making angle 30 degree. 30 degree का angle बनाया. So, accordingly, I am writing, let AB be the tree. And let C be the point from where it is broken, right? And let the broken part touches the ground at D such that angle ADC is equal to 30 degree. Such that angle ADC is equal to 30. Everything we have to write. Only then our solution will be considered completed. If you are starting it directly with the solution, then half marks will be deducted or some credit should not be given to you. So you have to explain it thoroughly, whatever is there in the figure, right? Then he says, distance between the foot of the tree to the point where the top touches the ground is 8 meters. This is the foot of the tree. This is the point where the top is touching the ground. Distance between the foot of the tree and this point, it is given to be 8 meters. Aap yahan pe likh do. Also, AD is equal to 8 meters. This is all explanation of the question that we are doing. Right? So, what we want to find in the end, he says, find the height of the tree. Chaliye, let us start with the target of finding the height of the tree. देखें जरा, ये जो मेरा tree है ना, ये AB है. इसमें दो parts हैं, AC plus BC. Figure के accordingly, because मेरे को जो work करना है, वो triangle में करना है. Triangle में ही मेरा जो काम है, वो इस question को का target achieve करवा सकता है, right? So I have to work in this triangle. This BC is out of the triangle. But can you tell me any side of the triangle which is equal to BC? बता सकते हो ट्राइंगल की कौन सी साइड बीसी के इक्वल होगी? इस ट्राइंगल एसीडी में विच साइड विल एग्जैक्टली इक्वल टू बीसी? एनीवन raise your hand so that I can unmute you. No one is here. Harjot se puchte hain. Ashima wants to tell. Haan ji, Ashima, you tell. Which side of this triangle will exactly equal to the BC part of the tree? Ashima, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Ashima, tell.
I'm CD.
Bilkul theek. This part is bending towards the ground. That means instead of taking this point to be B, I take it differently D. That means this BC is nothing but CD. That means my tree's height, which is AB, it is sum of the two lengths AC and CD. So my target is to find AC out of this triangle and to find CD out of this triangle. Very easy. I'm writing in triangle CAD. First of all, one thing that you want to find, that means AC. Another thing which is known to you, that is AD. And can anyone tell me what is perpendicular over base? That is tan theta. Perpendicular over base is tan theta. And what is the value of theta here? 30 degrees. So I would like to write it as tan theta. One thing which is to be find out. Another thing which is known. Accordingly, it becomes tan 30. AC, I need. AD is 8 and tan 30 is 1 by root 3. So AC is equal to 8 by root 3. Okay? So this is the value of AC. And my dear students, keep one thing in mind that whenever you are solving the questions related to, you can say, application of trigonometry and there is root in the denominator, do rationalization and keep that root in the numerator. Chalo, hum iski rationalization karte hain. Root 3 into root 3. So this is 8 root 3 over 3. Yeh mera AC ki value hai. Isko maine equation number 1 bol diya because this is to be used in the end. Now, let us see what we can do to find CD. Again, in triangle CAD. Now, some of the students say one thing which we want to find, another thing which is known to us. Students say they used to write CD over AD. CD over AD. Hypotenuse over base. This becomes secant. I don't want to use secant, cosecant and cot. Only three things I would like to use. One is sine, another is cos, and then it is tan. Because three trigonometric ratios values I have learned, rest I use with the help of these three. So better to, instead of writing CD over AD, let us write AD over CD. Koi farak nahi padega. What is AD over CD? Base over hypotenuse. Base over hypotenuse means cos 30. Right? And now you can see AD is 8. This is CD. This CD is, we want to find cos 30 is root 3 by 2. Now CD is to be find out. CD ko udhar le jao. Aur inko idhar le jao. This is 8 into 2 over root 3 is equal to CD. So, this becomes 16 over root 3. And again, I told you that root in the denominator is not desired at all to rationalization. 16 over root 3 into root 3 over root 3 is equal to CD. So you will be having 16 root 3 over 3 equal to CD. So this we are getting as the part CD. So in the end, we will write the height of the tree in actual. Let us write. Therefore, height of the tree, which is equal to AB and according to figure is equal to AC plus BC and according to our concepts is equal to AC plus BD. So let us replace the values AC plus CD. So according to our calculations, AC comes out to be 8 root 3 by 3 and CD comes out to be 16 root 3 by 3. So taking the LCM, same number is LCM, 8 root 3 plus 16 root 3. Bahut sari cheeze hain 9th ki jo hum use karenge. I told you that how to add irrational numbers. If root in the root, same number is there, then the addition is possible. See, same number under the root, root 3. So what will be 8 root 3 plus 16 root 3? This is definitely equal to 24 root 3. So we are having 24 root 3 over 3. Get cancelled. 8 root 3 meters unit is to be mentioned. This is the answer. That means height of the tree. स्लोली एंड स्लोली जैसे जैसे हम इस चैप्टर में आगे बढ़ेंगे देखना आपको कितना इंटरेस्टिंग लगेगा और आप खुद देखोगे कि मैं कोई अननोन स्टेटमेंट लेके उसके अकॉर्डिंगली समझ सोच समझ के उसकी फिगर बनाऊं इफ यू आर हैविंग दैट क्यूरियस माइंड दैट स्टूडेंट्स चैप्टर इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग फॉर यू क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड बस एक ट्रिक एक चीज जिसको फाइंड करना है दूसरी चीज जो गिवन है उनके बीच का रिलेशन और ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शन की वैल्यू एंड दैट्स इट इट्स ऑल द पर्पस क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड अ कॉन्ट्रैक्टर प्लान्स टू इंस्टॉल टू स्लाइड्स फॉर द चिल्ड्रन टू प्ले इन अ पार्क पार्क में बच्चों के खेलने के लिए स्लाइड्स आर टू बी इंस्टॉल्ड फॉर द चिल्ड्रन बिलो द एज ऑफ 5 वन स्लाइड इज फॉर द चिल्ड्रन बिलो एज ऑफ 5 एंड What she prefers for this slide, you know, for slide, there should be a ground level. There should be some perpendicular distance. And let us take this to be slide. She prefers to have a slide whose top is at a height of 1.5 meter. Is this slide ka top 1.5 meter ki height pe hai? Top of this slide, this is slide, top of this slide, is at 1.5 meter height from the ground. He says, and is inclined at an angle of 30 degree with the ground. Or this and this slide, it is making the angle of 30 degree with ground. With this, we have completed the figure for the people who are below age of 5. Let us see that what he is doing for the other age children. Whereas for elder children, बड़े बच्चे अगर छोटी स्लाइड उनको दो ना तो ये कहेंगे हमें बच्चों वाली स्लाइड दे दी इसलिए for the elder children, what difference she wants to make? She said that this time I will be having a slide whose height from the ground is 3 meter. Again, I am taking ground level. Let us take it differently. EF ले इसको. अब इसकी ग्राउंड से जो हाइट है वो है 3 meter एंड दिस इज द स्लाइड लेट इट बी PQR एंड व्हाट एंगल स्लाइड इज मेकिंग विद द ग्राउंड दिस टाइम 60 degree देखो एक चीज यहां से ऑब्जर्व कर रहे हो जब तो जैसे जैसे हमें एक वर्टिकल डायरेक्शन में ऊपर ऊपर देखना होता है वैसे वैसे हमें अपनी आई का एंगल बढ़ाना पड़ता है आपको पता है ऐसे कोई एक बंदा नीचे की तरफ आंखें करके खड़ा है उसने धीरे धीरे किसको देखना है धीरे 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 अपना एंगल बढ़ाएगा अपना फेस ऊपर करेगा करता 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 जैसे जैसे वो अपना फेस ऊपर करता है उसका एंगल भी बढ़ता जाता है इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सी टॉपर देन टॉप देन यू हैव टू इंक्रीज एंगल जैसे जैसे हाइट इंक्रीज हुई 1.5 मीटर से 3 मीटर हुई तो 30 डिग्री एंगल भी 60 डिग्री एंगल में बदल गया राइट एज वी आर इंक्रीजिंग द वर्टिकल डिस्टेंस नेचुरली ये आप मेरी आर्म को ही कंसीडर करो जैसे जैसे मैं वर्टिकल डिस्टेंस इंक्रीज करूंगी नेचुरली एंगल जो है वो बढ़ता जाएगा यहाँ पे 30 डिग्री था वर्टिकल डिस्टेंस बढ़ने से 60 डिग्री हो गया ये छोटी छोटी बातें याद रखनी है हमने बट द क्वेश्चन इज ही सेज व्हाट शुड बी द लेंथ ऑफ द स्लाइड इन ईच केस वेरी इजी In triangle CAB, now one known thing and one which is required, perpendicular over hypotenuse. कुछ बच्चे कहते हैं मैंने hypotenuse over perpendicular लेना ले लो hypotenuse over perpendicular cosecant है वो secant की values भी क्या याद करोगे फिर उसके लिए sine की help लोगे तो better है sine use करो perpendicular over hypotenuse this is sine 30 degree. So value of AC is 1.5. BC as it is, sine 30 1 by 2 cross multiplication gives you the length of the slide to be 3 meter. Coming to the another case, इन ट्राइंगल आर पी क्यू, यहाँ पे राइट एंगल जरूर बनाना है. अगेन आई एम टेकिंग पी आर विच इज गिवन टू मी एंड आर क्यू विच आई हैव टू फाइंड. दिस इज इक्वल टू साइन 60 डिग्री. राइट नाउ वट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ पी आर? दिस इज गिवन टू बी 3. आर क्यू वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट वट इज साइन 60. साइन 60 इज रूट 3 बाई 2. क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन, दिस इज 6 ओवर रूट 3 इज इक्वल टू आर क्यू. And again, my dear student, we are not going to leave root in the denominator. Rationalization is required. So 6 root 3 is equal to R cube. So when we will do the rationalization, root 3 se upar bhi multiply, niche bhi, we know this concept in 9th standard we have learned. So this is 6 root 3 over 3 is equal to PQ. And the answer comes out to be 2 root 3 is equal to PQ. So this should be the, you can say, length of the slide in the case of elder children, and this should be the length of the slide in case of the children who are below age of 5. देखो कितने interesting, ऐसे लग रहा है जैसे ये मैं question करवा रही हूँ ना, मुझे ऐसे लग रहा है वाकई में मैं किसी पार्क में खड़ी हूँ, वहां पे एक स्लाइड है उसको मैं देख रही हूँ, बच्चे खेल रहे हैं, कितना अच्छा मतलब हेल्दी सा माहौल है. राइट ऐसी चीजों को इमेजिन करो, बोर मत समझो स्टडीज को, ओनली देन यू विल बी एबल टू set a benchmark in the history of the, you can say, result of standard 10th, right? So, let us start with question number 4. Question 4 is, whatever situations are given in this question, one or the other time, we all have seen those situations. We all have been the part of those situations, right? So, इसलिए अच्छे लगते हैं questions. Question number 4. Angle of elevation of the top of the tower from a point on the ground, which is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower, is 30 degree. सिर्फ trigonometry, application of trigonometry के questions की एक ही बात जो है twisted होती है या बच्चों को थोड़ी सी you can say confused करती है. The thing is that whole information is given in one line. The line is so long, पता ही नहीं चलता कब शुरू हुई है और कितनी दूर जाके खत्म हुई. एक ही लाइन में सारी इंफॉर्मेशन. देखना मैं पढ़ूंगी, आपको लगेगा कि मैम जैसे किसी कोई किसी हिस्ट्री की कोई गाथा सुना रहे हैं. एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन ऑफ द टॉप ऑफ द टावर फ्रॉम ए पॉइंट ऑन द ग्राउंड विच इज 30 मीटर अवे फ्रॉम द टॉप ऑफ फुट ऑफ द टावर इज दिस. एक ही लाइन में सब कुछ बोल दिया. ठीक है, जैसे राम जो बहुत अच्छा लड़का है, सुबह रोज उठ के सैर करने जाता है और अपने माता पिता का आज्ञाकारी है, अपनी ऑनलाइन क्लासेस लगाता है, अपने टीचर्स की बातें मानता है, सब कुछ करता है, अच्छी अच्छी चीजें देखता है, सबके साथ प्यार से रहता है. मैंने उसको कभी नहीं देखा. मतलब मैं सीधा भी तो कह ही सकती थी मैंने राम को कभी नहीं देखा, राइट ना? इतनी लंबी चौड़ी कहानी बता के मैंने बताया कि मैंने राम को कभी नहीं देखा. तो यही बात इन क्वेश्चंस की है. एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन ऑफ द टॉप ऑफ द टावर फ्रॉम ए पॉइंट ऑन द ग्राउंड विच इज 30 मीटर अवे फ्रॉम द फुट ऑफ द टावर इज 30 डिग्री. मतलब इतनी ज्यादा इंफॉर्मेशन एक ही लाइन में देना ही इन क्वेश्चंस का वो ट्विस्टेड पॉइंट है जिसे अगर जिस स्टूडेंट ने पकड़ लिया उसके लिए एप्लीकेशन ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. सो वील कीप वील मीट टुमोरो एंड टिल देन जस्ट वन एक्सपेक्टेशन फ्रॉम यू पीपल. This time, make a habit, whatever we learn, especially in subject mathematics, we will make the notes side by side and we will not cheat from anywhere. We'll do the questions ourselves. If we need help, we'll see the lectures, tutorials in the YouTube, right? So hope so. You will keep all these things in mind because you are a very good class. So you're very good students of mine. And with this, I'm going to end the lecture.